Welcome guys, I am Parinita. Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to receive regular notifications regarding the computer science topics and technical job updates. Hello guys, in this video we are going to learn about DataMart. Now this is a very interesting topic to know, and also in terms of exam this is an important topic also. There are various types of questions that they are forming with the help of this DataMart. You may be asked that what is DataMart, what are the different types of DataMart, explain the different types of DataMart, or they may ask you what are the advantages of DataMart, what are the disadvantages of DataMart. They may ask you with the help of figure that what is the main difference between DataMart and data warehouse. Fine. So there can be various types of questions that can be formed with the help of this DataMart. So today in this video we are going to learn all about DataMart, so that if any such questions are thrown to you, you will be easily able to answer them. Fine. So let's start. First of all, let's see what is DataMart. What is actually the definition of DataMart? So we can say that DataMart is a subset of data warehouse that is generally oriented to a specific purpose that is designed for a particular department of any organization. That means what, as the definition suggests, DataMart is nothing but it is, you can say that, a subset of data warehouse. We know that data warehouse is all about bulk of data. Now if we take any specific particular type of data from that data warehouse, we can say that that will become our DataMart. Fine. So what is the specialty of the DataMart? That in the DataMart, generally the data is oriented to a specific purpose. Fine. We can say that DataMart is designed for a particular department of any organization. If data warehouse is containing all the data of the organization, we can say that its subset, that is DataMart, will contain only the information related to any particular department. Got it? I hope you are getting the idea. Now let's see this example. You will have a clear idea. In this example, consider that this is my data warehouse, and all these above, whatever you are seeing, these are nothing but DataMarts. Now the data warehouse, as we know, as we have already seen in earlier videos also, we have already seen about data warehouse. Data warehouse is what? It is, you can say that, bulk of data. It is containing bulk of data that may contain details regarding many various things, right? So here we are considering one data warehouse of the college. It is the data warehouse of the college. That means what? It will contain, data warehouse is actually the storage of bulk of data, nothing else. So this data warehouse of the college will contain various types of data, like data of college students, college faculties, college staff, details about college building, how many classrooms are there, how many how many machines are there, how many computers are there, what is the location of the college. It may contain the students' results. It may contain each and everything related to this college. Fine. So that is what we call data warehouse. It will contain bulk of data, each and everything of this college altogether in the data warehouse. Fine. Now, if I want to segregate the data and I want the data about specific departments individually, so what I can do from this data warehouse is containing everything, right? Now, from this data warehouse, if I want to take out the data of particular departments, like I want separate data for computer department, I want separate data for civil department, for electrical, mechanical department, how we can do? Now we can extract the subset of data from the data warehouse and we can call it DataMart of the departments. Got it? DataMarts of the department, these three will contain specific, or as you can see here, specific purpose. So it will contain the specific data of the particular departments. So we can say that these will be our data marts for the departments. Now if I again want to be more specific in this, what we can do? We can again extract the data of particular subject. For example, this is the computer department. So from the computer department, I want the details of the subject. Details means the syllabus, marks, or whatever. So from this computer department, I want the specific data for data mining, for data mining and data warehouse subject, for database subject, for operating system subject, like that. Again, fine. So similarly, from one data mart, I can again extract the things, or you can say that in this case, this will become our data mart and these will be working as data warehouse. Fine. So data warehouse is nothing but whatever more specific data we are getting, that is our data mart, and that superset of the data or the bulk of data is actually known as data warehouse. This is basically the main difference between them. Now, if you understood this thing clearly, other these points you can automatically have them in your mind. Now see, first of all, okay, let's see the advantages and disadvantages, and at the end we will see the different types of data mart. Now we have already seen the difference in detail. Now based on that, we can write our own advantages. Now what we can say, what are the advantages of the data mart? First one is easy access of frequent data. Whenever any data is occurring frequently, we can easily access them. For example, see, if I want any specific data for any specific department, and I want to find it out from this data warehouse, it will be difficult because it will be having so much of bulk of data. Finding any specific data from this will be difficult. But if I want the department data from this data warehouse, I can directly take it because it is having the specific information. Fine. So easy access of frequent data. So data mart allows us to access the data easily. That is the first advantage. The second advantage is improved access time, because obviously if we are easily able to access the data, the access time will also be increased. Here we have to find out from bulk of data, but here we can directly get the data. So access time will also be improved or increased in case of data mart. Actually, access time will be decreased. In less time we will get the data. So access time will be improved in case of data mart. Fine. The next one is faster and cheaper to build, because in this obviously the data is more in data warehouse, the size of the data is more, and so we want more storage, more hardware, more software, everything. So obviously it will be quite costlier, but in case of this data mart, we will be having small data, specific data, so faster and cheaper to build. Fine. And one more advantage is it stores focused data. Obviously, it is the main advantage that it is storing the focused data. It is storing only that much data in which we are interested in. Fine. Unlike this, in data warehouse, we are having all the data. We have to find out the area of our interest, or we have to find out our useful data. But in this case, it is only containing the focused data, or only containing the data in which we are interested in, or that is actually helpful to us. So data mart contains focused data, that is one of the advantages. And now if we see the disadvantages of data warehouse, these are the two main disadvantages of data warehouse, that is we cannot get varied detailed data from data mart. So yes, I am getting the data, specific data of the department, but if I want something else, for example, in this I am having the data of the computer department, but now if I want to compare the data of computer department and IT department, I cannot have it from here because there is no IT department, no data of IT department. But in case of data warehouse, as and when required, we can have detailed data, but in case of data mart, it is not possible. So that is one of the disadvantages. Second disadvantage is creating too many data marts become complicated sometimes. So yes, obviously in data warehouse, bulk of data or all kinds of data is available at a single place, but in case of data mart, for every time we want some new specific information, we have to create a new data mart. So it is actually a disadvantage, because creating too many data marts like that for every specific information, it may become somewhat complicated. Fine. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of data mart. Now, if we talk about, now at last, if we talk about the difference between, sorry, different types of data mart. So basically the data marts can be divided into, or can be specified into two different types, that is dependent data mart and independent data mart. Now, what do we mean by dependent data mart? As the name itself indicates, dependent data mart, what will happen in this, that the data mart is built by drawing data from the central data warehouse. Got it? Dependent, because this data mart will be dependent on the data warehouse. In this dependent data mart, we are simply taking out some specific data from the main data warehouse, and that data mart is made. So we can say that that data mart is completely dependent on this data warehouse. But in case of independent data mart, what happens that it is independent. So this data mart is built by drawing information or data from some external sources of data. Fine. in this case, so in case of independent data mart, we are not drawing or taking the data directly from the data house. We are bringing the data from some external sources and we are making the data mart for any specific data. Fine. So data mart, in dependent data mart, it will be completely dependent on data warehouse, but in case of independent data mart, it will be not dependent on data warehouse, but it will take the data from the external sources, so it will be completely independent of the data warehouse. Fine. So this is all about data mart. In case you are asked any question, if your understanding is clear, you can make the answers of your own. I hope this video was helpful. If you like the video, please share it as much as possible. And if you have not subscribed the channel yet, please subscribe the channel so that you will get such useful tutorials on the regular basis. Thank you so much.